Welcome back. This session we will see the addressing used in the network life internet, that is IP addressing. So every machine which is connected to the internet should be identified uniquely, right? For that we are using the IP address. So every machine will be assigned a unique address, and the specialty of this IP address is that it is formed in a hierarchical manner, just like our physical address. Like we can identify first the country of our address, then the state within the country, then within the country that district, right? Like that we can form a hierarchy. Finally, we can identify the corresponding house number, right? This is the way. Like that, every address in abstract way, we can divide it into two different parts, the network number and the host number. So as you know, the internet network contains a lot of networks, right? So using this network number, the corresponding network can be identified, and within that network, we can identify the corresponding machine using the host number. So this combination of network number and host number is always unique, and in principle, no two machines on the internet have the same IP address. And also, all the hosts in a network must have the same network number. So within a network, every host will have the same network number, and they have unique host number. And different network will have different network number. And in case of IP version 4, we are discussing about IP version 4 now. So 32 bits are used for representing an IP address. So the total number of machines which can be identified or addressed is 2 raised to 32. And one more thing to be noted is that actually this address identifies an interface to the network, right? That means that if a particular machine have multiple interfaces or multiple network to which it is interconnected, that much IP addresses will be there. For every interface, there will be an IP address. And who will assign this IP address to different machines? Yeah, just like as we have seen in the case of autonomous system numbers, these numbers are actually assigned by the organization, that is ICANN, Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers. And common assignment is done to avoid conflicts and all. Definitely, directly, each and every machine is not assigned by this ICANN. ICANN will be assign a block of address to a particular organization, and that organization will assign these numbers to the different hosts within that organization. And this ICANN actually delegates this power of assigning numbers or addresses to the sub-authorities. Those are actually regional authorities, regional registries, right? So particular corresponding to each region, there will be a regional registry. And those registry will assign IP addresses and autonomous numbers for the systems and organization under that region. That is how these numbers are actually assigned. You can see here an example for a network in which we have a router which connects different LANs or machines. Okay? Here we can see three different LANs are connected using this router. So this router has three different interfaces. So definitely this router has three different IP addresses. And as you see here, this IP addresses are represented using a dotted decimal notation. 32-bit numbers are used for IP address. So after every byte, there will be a dot in decimal notation. Okay. And two different addressing schemes are used in internet. First was the classful, and it is obsolete now. Now we are using the classless addressing. But by learning this classful addressing, this concept of addressing will be very thorough. So first, let us learn this classful addressing. Then let us move to classless addressing. So in case of classful addressing, entire set of IP addresses which can be formed using this 2 raised to 32 bits is actually categorized into five different classes. Class A address, class B addresses, class C, class D and class E. These are the different categories. You can see here the entire IP address we can divide into two different parts, right? First part, the higher order bits give the network number and the lower order bits give the host number. So in case of class A, first bit, the highermost bit always will be 0, and remaining 7 bits will indicate the network number, and the remaining 24 bits will be used to represent the host number. And in class B, first 2 bits, the highermost 2 bits will be 10, then the next 14 bits will be used for representing the network number, and the 16 bits, lowermost 16 bits will be used to represent the host. And for class C, this is the pattern. 21 bits represent the network number and the next 8 bit represent the host number. And class D is actually multicast. There is no division of network and host, but the entire set of bits represent a group address. Okay, so here we have 28 different bits, right? 4 bits are fixed, next 28 bits to represent the group, multicast group. That means 2 raised to 28 different multicast groups can be addressed. and class C is actually reserved for future use. Okay, so this is a classification. So in class A address, as you remember, the first bit, highermost bit, will be 0, and remaining 7 bits will represent the network number. That means we can have 2 raised to 7 different networks, right? And within each network, how many bits will be there to represent the host number? 24 bits are there. That means 2 raised to 24 different machines can be there within a network, right? So very large organization with a very large number of host machines, we can use this class A addressing scheme. So number of networks will be few, only 2 raised to 7 networks can be there, but all the networks can have this much host. And what about class B addressing? Yeah, the first 2 bits will be 10 fixed, and the remaining 14, here the 6 and the next 8, total 14 bits will represent the network number, and the next 16 bits will represent the host number. That means we can have 2 raised to 14 different networks, and within each network we can have 2 raised to 16 different machines. So middle level or medium sized organization, we can use this class B addressing scheme. Now what about class C addressing? Yeah, 21 bits are there to represent the network number, right? So 2 raised to 21 different networks can be there, and within each network we can have 8 bits to represent the host. That means 2 raised to 8 different hosts can be there. So for small networks, small companies and organizations, class C addressing can be used. And class D is actually for multicasting. 28 bits are used to represent the class D address. That means the 28 different 2 raised to 28 different multicast groups can be addressed. Some of the addresses in this classful IP addressing scheme is actually reserved for special purposes. So those are this shown here. First, all the bits in the IP address is 0. That means it represents the same host. At the time of booting and all, this machine can represent itself using this address. It doesn't know its IP address, right? So it can use this complete 0 address as its own address. And the second, network number 0. Host will be some particular address here, but the network number is 0. That represents the particular host within the local network. Okay. So in that case, only the corresponding packet move along the particular network itself to identify the corresponding host machine. And the third one, all the bits in the IP address is 1. That means broadcast on the local network. So that packet will be broadcasted only within the current network to all the machines in the network. And the fourth one is a particular network number with host address completely 1. That means it's actually broadcasting a packet, but it should be broadcasted to a network, distant network, whose ID is given here. So using this network number, that packet should be routed to that particular network, and there all the hosts within that network will receive the corresponding packet. And 127 as the network number, the first byte or first octet in this corresponding IP address is 127, means it should be a loopback packet within the same network. It will reach everywhere. This for testing and all, we will use this loopback address. So these are the different special addresses reserved. And the next we have address mask. As you remember, the main benefit of this IP addressing in classful manner is that every address can be divided into two different parts. So within a particular class, the fixed part always represent the network number, and the remaining will represent the host within that network, right? So using that network number, a router can easily identify to which network this packet is actually belongs to. So router, when it receives a packet, it have to find the corresponding network number, right? For that we are using this address mask. So in case of class A, as you remember, the highermost 1 byte is to represent the network number, right? So we have to extract that part from our received IP packet address, right? So whenever a router receives a packet whose destination IP address will be extracted first, from that destination address, the network number should be extracted. So for that, we are using the address mask. So to get the corresponding network number in case of class A, we have to extract the first octet, the highermost first 8 bytes, right? For that, we can use this address mask. That is, that part will be 1, and the remaining part, which represents actually the host number, that will be 0. And when we boolean add the IP address of the destination with this mask, by boolean adding the received destination address with this mask, it will get the network number alone, right? And using that as the index into routing table, it can find out to which outgoing line this packet should be forwarded. Okay, for that only we are using this address mask. So the corresponding dot decimal notation will be 255. That's all ones in the first octet, then all others are zero. This notation we will see later, slash 8. Okay, how many bits should be 1? That is the representation here. And for class B address, as you remember, the first 2 or highermost 2 bytes will be represent the network address, right? So that much bits will be 1 and the remaining will be 0. This will be the mask to get the network number. And for class C, this will be the mask. Okay, and these are the corresponding dotted decimal notation and these are the CIDR notation. The CIDR notation is actually classless inter-domain routing notation, which is used in classless addressing actually. Slash 8 means the first 8 bits would be 1 and remaining will be 0. Okay. And slash 16 means actually 16, the first highermost 16 bits should be set 1 and the remaining will be 0. And this is slash 24. Okay. And coming to classes and blocks. So when a particular organization need an address, IP address, it will request the corresponding local registry, right? And local registry will assign a corresponding set of IP addresses. Normally one particular network number or network address will be assigned to this organization. Okay, so definitely all the addresses within that network ID belongs to particular campus or organization. Yes, for example, if it requests for a class A address, if it is a very large organization, it requests for a class A address. So if it receives a particular network address in class A, how many addresses can be there in the corresponding block? Yeah, network ID will be same and it will it can have this much 2 raised to 24 different machines within that network, right? So that assignment of particular IP address to this particular host within a network, that is up to that organization. Okay, and registry will assign a particular network address to the entire network. And the problem with class A addressing is that only 128 different networks can be there in total, right? Yeah, that is very short in number. And if the corresponding organization is a medium sized one, it can apply for a class B address. In that case, it can get a network address belongs to class B. So within that network, it can have this much different hosts, right? 2 raised to 16, right? Yeah, 2 raised to 16 different hosts can be there within that organization, and assignment of address to these different hosts is up to that organization. And like that, how many class B addresses can be there? This much. So this much different networks can be there. So like that, class C, within each network only 256 different machines can be there. So for small networks only we can apply for this class C address. So usually what this organization will do, it will never apply for this class C address, right? Thinking that even if currently the number of hosts is very less compared to this 256, is maybe 10 or 30, they expect that in future the number of hosts may increase more, it may be more than 256. Assuming like that, it will request for a class B address. So the tendency is that all the organization will request for class B addresses. Definitely the class B address will deplete, right? Even if the total number of hosts in the entire world is less than 2 raised to 32, all will be assigned with the class B address, and the addresses, we will run out of IP addresses. That is the main problem with this class full addressing. So class full IP addressing, the main flaw is a block in class A address is too large for almost any organization, right? That much number of machines will not be there. And this means that most of the addresses in class A were wasted and were not used. What about B? A block in class B is also very large, probably too large for many of the organizations that received a class B block. And but all the organization will request for class B address, even though many of these addresses are actually wasted. And what about C? A block in class C is too small for many organizations, so they won't request for class C addresses.